You're calling for a review of the investigation. Explain to us why.
I think the first thing to, you know, to tell the general public is that the authorities haven't been doing anything proactive in the search for Madeleine for well over 2 years now, and we think it's fundamental for any major incident case review is undertaken to look at all the avenues that could be explored that might lead to new information coming into the inquiry.
You say that they've been doing nothing proactive. What have they been doing for the last two and a half years? People might be surprised to hear that.
Well, I think if information comes in, certainly to the British authorities, that if they're able to, they will have a look at it, and if they feel it's necessary, they'll send it over to Portugal. But they're actually waiting for information to come in rather than trying to bring information in that could find it.
Do you think it makes it difficult for them, though, because you have got your own private investigators looking for your daughter? Does that make the relationship with the police difficult?
Shouldn't. I mean, it's not competition. They should be working together, if anything. The fact if there wasn't private investigators, there'd be absolutely no one looking for this. So I don't see why. It's not a threat. We don't have the resources. They don't have statutory powers. So there's a lot more the authorities can do. We do have people, though, on the end of a phone line, looking at emails, interviewing witnesses, and generally following up new lines of inquiry. And they've passed a number of those on to the authorities. But, you know, this is an unsolved, serious case, and particularly given the profile, we think that a full case review should be undertaken. And that has to be collaborative with the Portuguese authorities.
Leicestershire Police have said to us that they haven't shelved the investigation because it was never their investigation to shelve, because it's been led by the Portuguese. What more do you expect Leicestershire Police to do?
I mean, I think it's important to say, although Portugal has primacy with regards to the investigation, it doesn't mean that there isn't things that the British authorities can do. And certainly a review is one of the crucial, significant things that they can take part in.
I mean, I think what we're asking for today is for the governments to do more. Leicestershire have, you know, largely played their part, and they've done that to the best of their ability. But this needs to be done at higher level. It needs to be done between the governments, and there has to be an agreement and parameter set in terms of a review, how it's going to be done and what it leads to. And the last Home Secretary, Alan Johnson, ordered a scoping exercise that was undertaken by CEOP. And as far as we can see, after 6 months, nothing's been done with that scoping exercise, and we just don't think that's acceptable.
So the previous Home Secretary looked into the feasibility of having a review. Has there been a change in the attitude of the new government now that we've had a change of government?
Well, it's difficult to know because we're not getting any metrics to measure what the government are doing against. So there's no timelines, there's no deliverables, and time's just ticking on. We were told that we would be told the contents of that report. We haven't seen it, we haven't been told. And really, although the government say there are sensitivities, we fully understand that, but they should be doing more, and they should be responsible for ensuring that Madeleine gets the best investigation possible.
We're not aware of any progress since the CEOP report was handed into the government at the end of March, and even allowing for a change of government in the last 6 months, we're not aware of anything that has carried on from that report being given in.
And you met with Theresa May, the new Home Secretary. What promises did she give you? Did she tell you what was in that scoping report?
Well, I think that's just it. There weren't any promises. In fact, she said, I don't want to make any commitments. But basically what we need to know is, what are they doing? What are they going to do with that report? Have they read the report?
Do you think she had even read it?
Well, she hadn't when we met her. She said that, which was a bit disappointing. Hopefully now she has, but we need to know, where are we going now? Because we truly believe it's going to help the search for Madeleine. We know it's not easy, but it doesn't mean it's not possible.
I just wanted to ask you, you've chosen to do the interviews now, 3.5 years on. People will be wondering how on earth you keep going and how you keep this story in the news after such a long time.
Well, we don't. Although
don't
we
know.
Offer to do things like this. Really, I think it's a reflection that the public are very interested. And
I think the public care about Madeleine, and that's why it's still a story, for want of a better word. Which is great, because without the public support, I don't know where we'd be.
I think that's crucial. You know, the government won't do anything without pressure, and it's the public, the government are accountable to the public who elected them, and that's what we're asking for, is the public to ask our government to do more and to work with the Portuguese government as well, and we should be putting pressure on both of them to solve this. We can't stop doing what we do. We need to find Madeleine. We live in a, you know, a life that's somewhat in limbo between our previous life, which is very, very happy, and somewhere now where we've got a different life, but without Madeleine in it. And we can't really get off that treadmill until we find her, or at the very least, what's happened to her.
And how do you keep going? How do you keep hoping? There must be days when it's very, very difficult.
I mean, we've worked so hard. I mean, understandably, we're Madeleine's parents. We're going to do everything that we can. And we work really hard, and there are days when it feels that obstacle after obstacle is thrown in your way, and obviously the clock keeps ticking, the calendar keeps turning, and there's days that we just look at each other and think, God, I wish it was all over, you know. But basically we wish Madeleine was back with us, full stop, you know, but we can't stop, you know, while we're in this situation we just have to keep going. It doesn't matter how tiring it is, it doesn't matter how many blocks are put in our way, we have to keep going, because a little girl is still out there missing. You know, this has not solved this case. She's still missing, and there's an abductor out there, there's a criminal out there who is free to do this over and over again if we let him. You know, so it's another reason why the governments and the authorities should be doing more.
I was just going to say, one of the you know, the simplest thing is Sean and Amelie's attitude, because they talk about Madeleine all the time, and when we're having one of those days where you just want it all to go away and you're feeling exhausted, and they just say, when Madeleine comes home, and there's no reason why she can't come home that we know of, and it's happened for other children, and they know how hard we're working, and they want Madeleine home as well, and that really does give us renewed energy and vigour to carry on what we're doing.
Now, in Sean and Amelie's words, Madeleine's missing. We need to find her. I mean, it's quite simple when they put it like that, you know.
So you still believe that your daughter is alive and out there somewhere?
Well, certainly we know there's a good chance that she's still alive. I mean, at the minute she's just missing, you know, so you have to assume she's alive, because there's nothing to say otherwise. There's many cases, as you know, that have hit the media of children, and many cases that haven't hit the media, of children who've been found years down the line. So you just have to keep going.
I mean, you could imagine that if we just gave up and years down the line we found her. I mean, there's no justification for giving up.
And so you keep on searching for as long as it takes.
Yeah, and we can't stop. I mean, I don't think any parent could stop.
I don't think you could live comfortably. I just don't think physically that you could, or mentally, you could actually reach that decision, you know.
When you mentioned the public support and how important that is to you, how do you feel about the fact that there are still people who feel that you had something to do with it, and there are websites set up to this, and it must be quite hurtful still after all this time?
Yeah. I think the key thing is that the motives of people who wish to persuade others that Madeleine is dead without any evidence to suggest that have to be questioned. You know, we're here to try and make sure there's as good a search as possible, and that's, as far as I can see, the way the vast majority of the public want to see it happening. And I think they'll be shocked to find that the authorities have not been doing anything. Our focus is in making sure there is a good search, not in stopping one for a missing child.
So are you still quite hurt by the things that you read?
Well, a lot of the rubbish I don't read, to be honest, because as Jerry said, you have to question the motives of people like that. People who want to insist on something without evidence, people who want to bring, you know, more pain and suffering to a family who are already vulnerable, who are already suffering. You really have to question those people. And I don't value their opinion, you know, because I wouldn't behave like that. So, you know, you can't be, you know, distracted from what is important, which is Madeleine, by people like that. The majority of people are good people. They're the quiet majority. And I strongly believe they're the ones that want to find Madeleine.
And you're appealing formal funds. What happened to the money that you had previously? There's around, I understand, £350,000 left. What happened to the previous money that was donated? Okay.
I think the first thing to say is that the priority today is very much about asking the public to help us with a petition to get the government to do more. We have been fortunate, although it's not helped us get what we want, by having a fund, and the fund was set up in response to people offering money, and it was set up properly, and the fund's very accountable, it's independent auditors, we have a fund administrator who's got lots of experience, but the vast majority of the money in the fund's been spent directly on search fees. It's obviously supported other things, awareness campaigns. We have a part-time coordinator now. We have a media liaison to deal with things like this here and in Portugal and trying to get our messages across. But most of the money, the vast majority of it, has been spent.
We've had to fund an investigation for 2 years now, which, as you can imagine, with several more than that personnel, it costs money, you know. And
staff, expenses, interviewing. We run a 24-hour helpline which is available. We run a website that costs money, updating it, communications, you know, all of these things do add up. And without having the fund, there wouldn't be a meaningful search today.
You've also spent money on your own investigators, as you said, and there have been reports that some of these detectives have taken money but they're not delivered. They're dodgy detectives, if you like. How can you reassure people that money won't be spent on people like that in the future?
Well, we've very much had, for the last 2 and a bit years, with a Dave Edgar, who's a very experienced detective who was near retirement. He's been working with us. He's very much accountable for the spend. He feels he can justify every penny. But at the same time, I hope public realise as well, as directors of the fund, and particularly when we were Arguido and there was no search going on, that it was incumbent upon us to continue a search in very, very difficult circumstances. So we have made decisions along the way which have always, we felt, been in the best interest of the search to find Madeline. And we're very accountable. All the expenses are there, receipts, and we've got quite a tight-knit team working on this. But we need them. Without it, there will be no one there to go and interview people and follow up leads.
But what about some people might say that the judgment of the trustees is sometimes questionable because you have employed people like Kevin Hannigan, who's now facing extradition?
Well, you know, we have doing the best in very, very difficult circumstances. I think that's key. We always take advice. Due diligence is done, references are sought, and, you know, the fund is accountable. And as directors, we're responsible for making those decisions.
And there are also reports that you'd fallen out with some of the trustees, your brother and your boss, who resigned.
That's nonsense. That's absolute nonsense. Why do you say we're falling out? I mean, the fund has changed over 3 years. 3.5 years. It was very different. Initially, we weren't on the board because
nobody
we were based
thought,
in Portugal.
You know, 3.5 years ago that we'd be in this situation today. It's a big commitment, you know, and things have changed. We've got different phases in the last 3.5 years, and inevitably there's going to be changes.
So it's not that you've had differences over the way the money was spent?
No, not at all. In fact, any of the changes we've made recently have to make the fund more efficient and more responsive. Kate and I always feel, you know, there's still an urgency. It doesn't get easier. And we don't need a large board as such. We're trying to run the fund like a small business in many ways, so that it's focused and that the directors, by and large, are hands-on and responsible for certain areas. Kate and I are integral to all the parts of it. We've got legal advice, we've got specialist media liaison, etc. We've got a retired accountant. And, you know, we've got Kate's uncle who is there and is a good governance sort of person. So all of these are taken on board, and we've got a very experienced fund administrator as well.
Have you talked about the petition?
Yeah. So, I mean, you've mentioned the petition already. Just how many signatures are you hoping to collect? What are you asking people to sign for? What's the point of the petition?
Well, the whole point is to call on the government, both the UK and the Portuguese government, to do more in the search for Madeline. And the first thing we feel that fundamental is that they undertake a complete review of the case, preferably it should be independent, and we want transparency as well. And we're asking the public to help us in that regard.
And in terms of, you only have 350,000 left now, how long do you worry that you can keep going on for if you don't get more donations?
Well, we're always, as directors of the fund, we're always looking at that, because one of the remit is for us to fulfil the objectives of the fund, and the fund is to try and find Madeleine and bring those responsible to justice. So there's always an agenda item about finances, and we need to look at that. We've done other fundraisers in the past, and we'll keep looking at that. We've been very fortunate from the point of view of having so many of the public made donations, and a large part of the money we've spent, as you know, has come from libel damages which were paid into the fund. So we'll continue to explore it. We certainly need to be looking at income generation over the next months.
There must be a huge pressure on you, knowing that you've always got to look for money though.
Well, I mean, we'd love nothing more to find Madeleine, and then we wouldn't have to worry about that. You're absolutely right. Our focus is in search for Madeleine, and without the authorities conducting that, then the onus is on us, and we don't think that's right. The onus should be on the governments to do more. We'd love to give that pressure away. You're right.
And you mentioned the libel trials. How do you feel now that Amaral's book is going to be on the shelves here?
Yeah, so, well, you know, as we've already alluded to, anyone who wants to convince people that Madeleine is dead without evidence to support it, their motives have to be questioned. But today the focus is on asking the public to help us petition the governments to do more.
Do you feel that you should be chasing libel action? Some people might say, why don't you just leave all the libel stuff to one side? Why try and silence your critics?
Well, obviously we've talked about this in great detail previously. The reason why we had to take action was because we strongly felt it was damaging the search to find Madeleine, and as Jerry's just said, that is our ultimate goal, is to find Madeleine.
And just finally, can you update people, where are you now? I mean, recently you went over to Germany, you translated all your literature into German, so can you update people, where are you now? Have you got any new leads? What's happening with your investigations?
I mean, I'd like to say to you that we did have some hot leads, but I mean, the very fact that we're calling for a complete review to identify further areas for investigation is telling you that, you know, more needs done. All the information needs to put onto one database, because that may be the way that we find the key bit of information, a missing piece of the jigsaw.
So at the moment you're worried that there isn't even a central database, so the information won't be not getting across records.
There's information in lots of different centres that hasn't been brought together, and there could be two key bits of information that individually don't seem key, but put together could give you some valuable information that could take you that one step closer to finding Madeleine. So it just seems an obvious and crucial thing to do, and this is why reviews are done time and time again in this country on major investigations.
So you must be frustrated that the government has carried out a scoping study into whether there should be a review, but then no action has been taken.
Yeah, I mean, that's what we're asking for. We want to see what action, we want metrics, we want deliverables, and we want the government to do more. Madeleine's a British subject. The government should be doing more to look out for her best interests.
And just wondering, how can people sign the petition?
So it's on the iPetitions website, so it's www.ipetitions.com and then /petitions, but it's quite a complex link.
We'll put it on our website.
Thank you.